Hey all you cool pups and pooches, my name's Spokes, and my mom Sammy is an educator at the Perot Museum of Nature and Science. This is her right here. She asked me to talk all about dog physiology, or how us dogs work and what makes us so awesome. So I challenged a bunch of my friends to do some tricks with their humans to show off some of our most athletic adaptations. Try some at home with us. The first challenge is all in the legs. Our hind legs are perfectly adapted for jumping. See how Maggie's ankles are higher up than her mom's? This allows our legs to act just like a spring. That's how we're so agile in the wild, especially when looking for squirrels. Ask your human to do a math trick and measure the length of your back legs, your spine, and the height of your jump. That way, you can compare your jump to dogs of other sizes. My friend Evie is much shorter in both directions than my friend Sam, but look at the air she gets. Oh, and this is my friend Rexy. She's a pretty funny looking dog and can't really jump that high, but she has a great personality. Okay, now on to our amazing noses. Have your human hide some of your favorite treats under a cup that you can't see through next to a couple of empty ones and see how long it takes you to sniff it out. Probably not long. Our noses have over 300 million olfactory receptors, and your human, they only have a measly 6 million. The part of our brain that interprets all of these smells is also about 40 times bigger than a human's, but we love them anyway. We also like to keep our noses a little wet. It helps us collect scent molecules in the air. Our brain can then determine smells in both directions, which makes us perfectly adapted to find food under these silly cups. Hey, get out of here, Vincent! Wrong species! Okay, now let's get back to business and talk about our eyesight and snout-eye coordination. Us dogs get a pretty bad rap when it comes to our vision. Time to do some debunking. Dogs don't see in black and white. Our retina actually contains two types of cones, or color receptors. Ones that detect shades of blue and yellow, but not red. However, we do have lots of rods, the part of our retina that senses motion. This is what makes us so great at playing catch and fetch, when we feel like it. Oh, Merlin. Now, not all of us will catch the ball 100% of the time. Keep practicing, Rexy, you got it. I got it. I totally meant to do that. But anyway, me and my friends are actually much better at seeing motion at night when it's dark out. That's right, night vision. My eyes aren't glowing, that's just my tapetum lucidum, or the layer behind my retina, reflecting more light for me to be able to see. Now, just like humans, we each have our own unique and special talents, like getting the mail for our humans, or chasing it away. How about outsmarting puzzles? That was easy. Some of us like to take our humans for a quick ride around the block, or have snowball fights and make snow angels together, or finding the most efficient way into the human's lap. How about sneezing on command? But most of us like to just take a nice long nap. My personal favorite. See you next time when we get to amaze our brains together at... Bye!